In this video, we'll be finding the third angle of triangles. The sum of the interior angles is equal to 180 degrees. So, to find the missing angle, we subtract the sum of the two angles that we know from 180. Well, suppose we have a triangle, but we only knew the degrees of two of the angles, but we wanted to know the degree of the third one. In this case, we know one of the degrees is 85 and the other is 80. And we're just going to call the one that we don't know x. To find x, we're going to subtract 85 and 80 from 180 and set it equal to x. When we subtract 85 and 80 from 180, we get 15 for x. You can also look at this as an equation. In this case, the equation would be 85 plus 80 plus x is equal to 180. And then we would solve this like a regular equation. Using both ways, we got 15 degrees as our answer, and I'll show you why in just a minute. When you add the inside angles of every single triangle on the face of the earth, you always get 180 degrees. Okay, so we're being asked to find r, and we happen to know 2 degrees of the triangle. 32 and 125. We're going to subtract those 2 degrees from 180. And when we subtract 32 and 125 from 180, we get 23. Okay, another way to do this is by solving the equation 125 plus 32 plus r is equal to 180. And then we combine 125 and 132 and get 157 plus r is equal to 180. Then we subtract 157 from both sides and we end up with the same answer. R is equal to 23. And we know this is true because 23 degrees plus 32 degrees plus 125 degrees is equal to 180 degrees. On our next problem, we're being asked to find B. And in order to find B, we subtract 90 and 40 from 180. We know that one of the angles, even though it doesn't say 90 degrees, it shows us a sign for a right triangle. B is equal to 50. The algebraic reasoning to this would be an equation. So 40 plus 90 plus b is equal to 180, and 40 plus 90 is 130, so we rewrite that as 130 plus b is equal to 180, then we subtract 130 from both sides, and we get b is equal to 50. To be completely honest, the second method is a bit tedious, so I would just use the first method because you get the same answer. And again, B is equal to 50 degrees. Okay, so our last problem is the most tedious of all the examples that we've done. We have to remember that a straight line, like a triangle, has a degree of 180. So to find the degree of the inside angle, we subtract the degree of the outside angle from 180. Since 180 minus 110 is equal to 70 degrees, we know that 70 is the degree of our interior angle, of our first interior angle. To find our second interior angle, we do the same thing. We subtract 130 from 180, and we get 50 degrees. Now that we know two of our interior angles, we can subtract those from 180 to get our third interior angle. 180 minus 70 minus 50 is equal to 60. So we know that Z is equal to 60 degrees.